Welcome to Christian Statesman. I'm your host, Zach Wagner, and this is episode 85, Dimming America's Light. Since its inception, America has been the city on a hill, a light of freedom beaming to the world. It is founded in the concept of limited government, individual rights, and the sanctity of private property. These are all concepts that, in the 1700s, were anathema to the royal hierarchies that had dominated Europe and Asia for millennia. It is the greatest experiment in liberty and human potential in the history of the world. No previous nation can compare to the magnificent concepts laid out in our Constitution. And since America's inception, those dark elitist powers have amassed their influence and wealth to stifle or alter the American experiment. And over the course of the last century or so, they have been reasonably successful at shifting the American experiment. We must keep in mind that for as long as history has been recorded, there has been one section of the population that has sought control and dominion over others. Perhaps the most liberating principle that has forged America's exceptionalism is the entrepreneurial spirit and opportunity. For many years, capital and resources were available for the business-minded individual that had a better idea, product, or system that could be sold at a profit to the public. Nearly every modern convenience we now take for granted had its origins in the small entrepreneurial endeavors from someone who felt inspired to innovate. Large corporations have contributed their fair share to our prosperity, but they have been eclipsed by the little guy who simply learned how to build a better mousetrap. That little guy may have sold his ideas to a larger entity eventually, but the cash was in his pocket, not some regulatory agency or bureaucratic elite. It is upon that principle as much as any other that America has been founded and prospered over the years. And those entrepreneurial ideas spawned numerous companies that created millions of jobs that enabled a burgeoning middle class to develop. That middle class defined this country for several generations, where a decent education and a decent job offered a home, car, food, and the luxuries of life that were reserved for royalty just a few centuries earlier. The invasion and evisceration of these principles is showing openly now, as we see more and more legislative overreach, more medical tyranny, and more imposition onto the choices and liberties of our daily lives. These impositions are destroying mainly small businesses, those struggling entrepreneurs trying to make it bigger and better, while certain selected large entities prosper like never before. This is a de facto transference of wealth from the little guy to the large entity, a transference that seeks to dim America's beacon of hope and create a technocratic fascist state where only the grandiose, powerful, and connected will thrive. And we will soon see the next step in the plan to dim our entrepreneurial light as a social credit system based on intersectional and environmental political correctness is rolled out. The small business person may be cut off from credit, marketing, and other necessary lifelines for prosperity if they so much as think or speak incorrectly in the context of prevailing leftist ideology. What we are witnessing before our eyes under the current administration is a transition from free market to fascism. This transformation has been going on for some time, but the elitist powers are moving quickly now to seal the deal. The first stage occurred over the last century as we moved from a fairly undiluted form of capitalism to an ever more corrupt crony capitalism. This is now transitioning to a full-on fascist state where only those in line with prevailing government ideology will prosper. Through these mechanisms, it is now government that is picking the winners and losers, and not by virtue of their innovation, but by their conformance to political thought. Nothing defines the desire to create a technocratic fascist state more than the pending strategy to tie all businesses to an ESG rating. This system, which stands for Global Environmental, Social, and Governance Rating, will assign a value to a business based on what the purveyors of the business believe, not what they actually do, but whether or not they are subscribing to correct ideology regarding the environment, social engineering, and other factors based on politics, not markets. All business undertakings under this system must align themselves with the prevailing political demands over and above market or consumer demands. This is techno-fascism at its finest, and it is coming soon to your business. If you're an entrepreneur, you will not be able to do business with other companies or suppliers if you are deemed politically deficient in any of the rated areas. Who does the rating and how do you conform is not particularly clear. If you are working for a large company, you may risk your job and career for incorrect thought or speech. George Orwell must be spinning in his grave. If you want to destroy the dream that was America, take away the entrepreneurial opportunities. Everything else becomes academic after that, and the current administration is cooperating with an agenda that does exactly that. America's light will dim and then be extinguished if the entrepreneur loses. And under years of corrupt crony capitalism, draconian COVID restrictions, and upcoming ESG requirements, that light will be dim indeed. The royal hierarchies of the past are consigned to the pages of history, but the new hierarchy is the technocratic and ideologically driven government-favored corporation. As the old 70s rock song goes, meet the new boss, same as the old boss. Thank you for being with us. Please subscribe, and as always, have a wonderful day.